being shown the PE inside so proudly as he banks away, smoke trailing. What an awesome demonstration of gyroscopic aerobatics this is.
Looking to your hand sky now, we see patches of blue still, which is rather nice. It's certainly not that pleasant afternoon, it's just more cloudy than it was a little earlier when we were bathed in sunshine. It is the smoke from the sector drifting slowly across the sea. You can kind of eerie feel actually, almost like an early morning mist. But there's a lot of smoke coming out the back.
And the wing waggle there from Rich Goodwin, and already you're cheering and clapping. I think that was very much enjoyed by everyone down on the beach. As it was here up in the country, we really enjoyed seeing the muscle biplane pit demonstration from Rich Goodwin.
Let's hear it for Rich. And he's a slow, let's give him a round of applause. Just arriving over the pier and flying past the BBC Essex commentary point. This is the P-51 North American Mustang. And it's being flown by an absolute star from Northfield. It hasn't had to come far today. Peter Teichman is at the controls of the Mustang. So listen to that sound, and in absolute awe, my guest expert, Sam, you would love to be doing what Peter Teichman is doing right now, wouldn't you?
Absolutely. I think the Mustang is quite possibly my favourite in the world. Absolutely love watching Peter display. He's such an incredibly talented display pilot. And this is a very special aircraft. It is an American long-range two-seat fighter getting fighter on it, reaching world war II, New York, and other countries. So let's watch as we see one of the most famous fighters of World War II, the P-51 Mustang, which looks by Ableton and the USA.
Yeah,
he
said it in a joke.
Where are you going to stay in the middle?
But I absolutely love it, and I can't wait. That's an interesting shot. We've got the wind turbines, the air blades turning, and the Chinook is coming over them with its two blades turning as well. You're going to be taking us through the action on BBC Essex.
That's gone there.
Matthew, thanks very much. Well, good afternoon. As you said, my name's Mark Jeffrey Finchbarlow, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to the 2018 Royal Air Force Chinook Blade here in Paxton. The aircraft being flown for the first time this year is our latest upgraded Chinook, known as the Chinook Mark 6A. If you look now towards the display area, you see the mighty Chinook on its initial running at 120 knots low level. The crew has just pulled up by 45 degrees into the nosegover. Descending down now into the 90 degree breakaway, the ship size often hides its ability, power and performance, but hopefully it never fails to impress you. The 2018 display team pilot and aircraft captain is flight attendant Stu Pinocchio.
you know, the 27-year-old operational pilot and training captain. He joined the Air Force in 2007 and was posted to Rogue Enterprise Connection in 2011. Since arriving on the force, he's been part of exercises and operations around the globe, including the Falkland Islands and four operational detachments to Afghanistan, amassing over 1,300 flying hours. As they've gone out to the left, you'll see the aircraft pitch up by 45 degrees and complete a pedal turn to the left. At this point, Kino's unable to see the ground from the front seat, rapidly scanning sideways, picking markers to ensure he has the correct pitch in the time whilst he keeps his wings level. This manoeuvre enables the crew to turn the aircraft really quickly, dissipating its energy for a late spot of troops. As they come down the cloud now from left to right, the aircraft has been pulled up by 45 degrees into the roller coaster. Stu's again scanning from side to side, picking up his lateral markers. The challenge here is ascending before descending onto the crowd centre, the three boys you can see in the middle of the display area, whilst he's battling his 14-ton machine, which is being pushed and pulled by the wind. And they have a nice extending onto the crowd centre before pitching up again. Joining Stu in the cockpit today is the 2018 display co-pilot, Matthew Schnitzel Smythe. Flight attendant Smythe joined the Air Force in 2007 before qualifying on Schnitzel in 2011 and joining the Fighting 27 squadron. Since joining the squadron, he's gained over 1,300 hours on site and deployed four times to Afghanistan. He's taken part in multiple training exercises throughout Europe and America, as well as his attachment to the Falkland Islands in the South Atlantic.
Now we start with Togo.
As the crew now run out to the right-hand side, he'll pull up by 25 degrees into an offset right-hand winger. As he comes around, listening carefully, you'll hear the distinctive rotor noise get louder and louder. This waka-waka sound is synonymous with Chinook, and it leads to our popular Twitter hashtag, BladeFlap. There's the three looks for BP aircraft. You'll get to see these as he goes under, and a great under silhouette of the aircraft.
They're all there poaching it in a big view.
Yeah, they have. The BladeFlap sound is mighty to there as it comes by. So these unsung loads can be anything required, from food, water and supplies, to ammunition, artillery, guns or vehicles. We routinely move 10-ton shipping containers this way, as seen in our support to the Caribbean last year after Hurricanes Irma and Maria. We can also undertake any other UK helicopter, even another Chinook. As the crew turn out now, they conduct a 30-degree wing over to position for a crowd centre nose over, and this is a great chance to get your cameras ready. The display you see today really demonstrates how manoeuvrable this extremely large helicopter is. Most of the display is all about the tactical skills deployed and perfected in operations around the world. During these manoeuvres, the co-pilot is capturing the aircraft speed, pitch and roll parameters and distances, alongside other information to allow someone to fly visually out of the window. They provide him the ability to tighten everyone's limits, but the confidence to not go beyond. Watch now as the crew pull up into the nose over.
There's definitely less.
Less ones.
They
don't have
no
night, shall we? They've been back for us. Citizens have been serving for many areas as well, including Afghanistan, Jordan, the United States, the Mediterranean, and Falkland. He recently supported operations in the Caribbean, where he contributed to the UK division of Asia region in the wake of Hurricanes Irma and Maria. So there he is now, if you see him on the map with both his big orange hands waving at you. As you see him come down, please give him a big wave and don't forget to place your big orange hand photos to show your support. If we're getting this right, from the left hand side of Praxiteer all the way down to the one up, we've got the world's slowest Mexican wave right now. The crew's primary role is to manage the fast and variable load configurations that Chinook can carry, both internally and externally. Alongside voice commands to position the aircraft accurately, for example in dust, picking up underslung loads, or landing on mountain ridges, these two deliver weight and balance, centre of gravity and dangerous goods specialisation to the aircraft captain, as well as servicing the deployed aircraft, rescue hoisting, or manning crew serve weapons if required.
That's it, that cloud's past over now.